young, aspiring hip hopper. All of you warmed my heart to see all of you wanting to do hip hop.
Bingo! Nicki Minaj!
I'd like to know if I can borrow the time machine that you used to go and get that outfit from Jody Watley on Soul Train in 1985.
Sir, you have cornrows and new groove. What is with that? You look like Jim Jones and Beanie Siegel had a love time. Come on! Make an appointment with the hairstylist.
And you, baby girl,
baby girl. Dragon Ball JV. If Pokemon were against the rapper, you'd be in style. All right, and you, Mr. Black Man with Puerto Rican head. What's with this heart of you? It's 900 degrees in here. You look like Kanye East. Enough of my rambling. I brought some specialists here today. Please give it up. For Elzai and Kate Porgy Kennedy.
Rule number one. First you gotta grab the right beat. You comfortable enough on the track to have a seat and put up your feet or lay down. I'm about to teach you how to train your dogs to sit and stay down. And you don't wanna get one too fast. You sound like outcasts and you won't outlast them. Cause when doubts flash and you shout and you pout, it comes out ass. And then you and your crew is without cash. So you gotta find a beat like this one. If the track is whack, you skip them. If the track is how you pick them. And that's when you dip them. And that's when you flip them. And that's when you give them. The niggas like us to rip them.
Lesson two, after you find a beat best for you, spot the rhythm. If not, your writtens is unacceptable. You gotta learn to ride the track. Know the bass and the snares basically there to provide the pace that guides your rap. When you chosen a part, the flow should just start from scatting. The moment it sparks, you're composing the art and what happens. You might say something like Dona Nanilla. Observe how Dona Nanilla are turning the words to knowing is iller. Or the flow is a killer. Just showing you niggas how to stay in the pocket. It's very valuable, so pray that you got it. Lesson three is established. And patterns, which is the synthesis gathering, putting emphasis on different ones. Imagine if you rode cheap skates, with cheap skates rhyme with deep lakes, and deep lakes rhyme with sweepstakes. Now check out my wordplay. I might switch the last word with the second and place the second with a third late. Nah, you got cheap skates, sweepstakes, and deep lakes. That's three great double syllables. Now we can create. Nah, bump a cheapskate. You thought I won a sweepstakes in the hundreds that can build up till it fill up a deep lake. That's what you call a three pattern. If we battling, and I use that, you cats will be least challenging.
Rule number four, here we go. I'ma teach you how to be witty. See, many think when they write rhymes, they need similes. But I'ma show you different tools of language that you use to distinguish you from the wanksters. And you ain't always gotta use like an ass. It's like ass if you gotta say you cut like glass. Are you fast as a motorbike? Let me show the right way you supposed to write to kill these niggas at an open mic. And you ain't gotta use a metaphor. Tell that nigga next time he tell you how fly he is, his head a sore. Or you can say something to him like I ruin your whole crew and turn your home to the Roman ruins. Keep doing what you doing and I'ma start pursuing a pallbearer and a black casket to put you in. Now that's a different kind of punchline. Bust rhymes, eat niggas until they can't chew cause it's too painful. And you'll get a reaction from the crowd that's so loud. Here throwing a towel, then bow. Lesson five, you gotta strive not to forget imagery. If you see what I'm saying, then it'd be more interesting if I'm able to put these words in a sentence and you can envision and mention everything you heard. What you got is a visual scripture. It's a little more crisper. It's the difference between a scream and a whisper. All in all, a colorful mixture. I'm a painter, my words the brush, and it's for us to paint pictures.
Make me see without using my eyes. It's an illusion that lies in the music and tries to give views to the wise and open-minded. I wrote a line that shows this, and it goes this. A black stone was covered in red roses. Number six. It's what you learn to make nothing but a hit. Of course it's the beat, but it's linked with the chorus you coming with. If your mission's to go pop and it's not strong, you're missing a shot on a hot song that'll make the listeners cop. See, this what you drop. Drugs, sex, murder, and money. It can also be big if the kids confirm it is funny. Ladies like a gimmick when you write intended to be sold to the women, and that'll hold their attention for like a minute. Now, since we know the basics, we gon' go and make it happen. Create the scatting just to show the flow and placement. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, something like that. That's the gist of it, but this is what it really sounds like.
You gotta find a melody in a chorus, make it simple so they can remember it. They gon' let you know if it's hot or not, wherever they go, they say your lyrics. You gotta find a melody in a chorus, make it simple so they can remember it. They gon' let you know if it's hot or not, wherever they go, they say your lyrics. You gotta find a melody in a chorus, make it simple so they can remember it. They gon' let you know if it's hot or not, wherever they go, they say your lyrics. You gotta find a melody in a chorus, make it simple so they can remember it. They gon' let you know if it's hot or not, wherever they go.